I'm Valerie. I'm a pet care advisor, and today I'm here with my friend Tubbs. Tubbs is a teddy bear hamster, and we're going to be talking about housing for hamsters. Hamsters are fun, engaging pets. They're relatively easy to care for, so a lot of times they may be selected as a child's first pet. When you get your hamster, they're probably going to come with a little cardboard carry box from the pet store to bring them home. That carry box is only a temporary housing for just a couple of hours. They can easily chew through that. So you do want to have a cage in place and set up before you bring your hamster home. You don't want him sitting in that cardboard box for too long. So cages can come as simple as this. Now this actually is an all-in-one kit. This is the Super Pet My First Pet Home. And this is the basic one-story model. You can see that it comes equipped with a wheel. It has a little shelf, a ramp, a water bottle, and a bowl. You can get actually higher level models where they have more shelving, but they, you know, basically that provides everything that you need. Super Pet also makes the Critter Trail line of products. This is the Critter Trail 1, and it's just one story, but inside this one story you can see that there's a wheel inside, there's a bowl, a water bottle. It even has this little petting zone here where you can reach in and pet the animal up close. There's a climbing tube here. So that's a different style of cage. Critter Trail makes higher models with, you know, 2 and 3 stories. They also make this Critter Trail X, which actually has a fancy wheel thing at the top, and I think there's a spiral staircase in there. These Critter Trail cages can all be connected. You can buy additional tubing and connectors to make a little village. So whether or not you have the space for something that elaborate is going to be up to the area of the house where you're going to place the hamster. You may already have a cage that you want to use for your hamster, in which case you may need some new accessories, such as a stoneware dish is a nice dish because it's durable, it's chew-proof, and this is a lot sturdier than some of these plastic ones that come. Water bottles are also available separately. This water bottle you can actually get with a chew guard. Sometimes the hamster will chew on the plastic, so you want to make sure that that's protected with the metal chew guard. Other things that you could get for your hamster enclosure might be some sort of a hidey box. This is just a cardboard box I made for Tubbs. He was staying overnight at my house, so I gave him that so he felt secure. You can purchase other type of hidey things. Some hamsters are just as happy to make a nest out of the bedding, so you may want to provide some soft, clean paper bedding, such as that Carefresh. That's the confetti color Carefresh. It's fun. It's got multiple colors in the paper. Your hamsters are going to need exercise too. So exercise can be accomplished by using the wheel. Now, hamsters are nocturnal by nature, so what they tend to do is sleep during the daylight hours, and then they're active at night. And they may spend a great deal of time on the wheel, and you want to maybe keep that in mind. The wheels sometimes can make noise. If you have the cage situated in a child's bedroom, it may be disturbing to the child to hear that wheel noise all night and, you know, keep the child awake, so that's something to consider. The wheels can be purchased separately if you don't already have one inside your cage. It really does give them a lot of activity at night, though. And during the day, you can actually get a hamster ball if you'd like. The balls roll around the house, or this one actually has a stand where it can stay stationary. When you put the hamster in the ball, they're going to roll around, so you want to make sure that they're only in there about 15 minutes so that they don't get, you know, tired in there. Also, you want to avoid direct sunlight when they're rolling around so that they don't overheat. Also, block off stairways so that the ball doesn't go rolling down the stairs. That wouldn't be very good. One question would be, can you have more than one hamster in an enclosure? Well, it depends on the species. Tubbs here, being a teddy bear hamster, is a Syrian hamster. Golden hamsters, common hamsters, teddy bear hamsters are all considered Syrian hamsters, and these guys are solitary. They prefer to live alone. If you house two together, they would fight and probably kill each other. There are dwarf species of hamster, Chinese, Russian dwarf hamsters, Siberian hamsters. They are more social and can live a couple to an enclosure, making sure that you have ample space for all of them. But these are some of the tips about hamster care. I hope you found this helpful, and thank you very much.